I'll do a slow pan.
Today in the garden, I'm going to create a piece live. So this is a pretty large piece. It's 3 feet by 4 feet. I like to do a lot of large paintings when I'm out on site. So it's more fun. You can be more big and gestural, still get some like details in. So usually I'm out on landscape painting, like out in the open. But since I'm here in the garden, as I was coming into the Santa Fe, I was just seeing the mountains in the sky. I did some sketching just of the big sky and mountains. I'm going to do a little bit of just painting for memory. So I'm going to try to play with the mountains and the sky, just kind of improv it, and I think it's going to be fun. So the first thing I do is put the paint out. I paint pretty thick in pastel, so I use a lot of white paint. So I buy these big cans of it, which, believe it or not, sometimes I go through a whole can in one or two paintings. So a lot of paint. I'm often hiking, like sometimes I'll put this on my shoulder and the canvas and I'll hike like maybe a mile or so out or even more up in the mountains or the ocean. So I keep my palette pretty limited, so I usually only use primary colors, and I use usually two of these colors. So I like for yellow, I'll use a cadmium yellow lemon, and a pure, one's a warm yellow, one's a cool yellow. So you get a warm and a cool of each color, and then just use primaries. You pretty much get the whole range of colors that you want. And it makes you mix it all, which I think gives you better color than if you bring out your color, all your colors. So anyway, that's how I've always done it. A lot of oil in there. Paper towel to blow, and you'll see me sprinting across to get the paper towel, so don't leave cracked out. And I'm sure if someone was saying it, it would be comical.
All right, I'm ready to paint. So
So I've got it all laid out. I usually paint mostly with these knives. I think especially when I'm painting location and you're putting wet on wet, the knives just lay the painting or the colors purely over each other, where brush metal it. So it's much easier to clean up. So I don't have to wash brushes when I'm done. So I enjoy that. Alright, so I've done, usually I'm out on scene, I did a few like really loose gestural sketches of some of the skies and the mountains. I'm not going to do it based on any of these, you can see they're very loose, but it kind of gets the energy. Sometimes it just helps you remember it, like you sketch it and you're like thinking about it, so now doing it from memory, the fact that I sketched it. When you're going from memory, a big thing is the shapes of the actual world are so varied and creative that when you're going from memory, sometimes the shape would be simple. So I am. Oh. Hey. Great to see you.
Great to finally meet you.
Great to meet you.
Really happy to meet you.
All right.
So sorry.
Ready to start painting. No problem. All right.
Must be painting.
Oh, hi. Yes, I am. Hi, I've heard about you.
I'm going to start by using this like a black, and I almost sketched it on the canvas. I used to not do this. I started in the last year doing kind of a sketch beforehand just to play with the shape and composition before I get going, and then actually letting some of that come through. I think it leaves a real energy under the painting. So I'm just going to start going. I kind of paint pretty improvisationally, so. Kind of base it off the mountains I saw that I was driving to Santa Fe. So obviously since it's memory, the shapes are not going to be exact, but I think I can still capture some of the feeling I had more as I remember it as I was driving in looking at this base.
Thank you.
hands of him. Baby, let me cry. Baby, let me cry. Baby, just let me. 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 Baby, just let
me. Baby, just let me. I had a lot of landscape painting tutorials that often tell you to, like, paint from the back and move to the foreground, which makes logical sense because you're covering things up, it's cleaner. But I don't do that because I like to think of the piece as, like, one more cohesive piece rather than, like, background, foreground. So, you'll see, I move all around so that it's always, like, working in balance with each other.
Thank you.
As I was driving out here, I got to come from California, so I drove across Arizona, and then also seeing the big looming mountains, I drove into Santa Fe. So, not an exact spot, but sort of a memory of the clouds and sky. Typically, I paint out on location, but it's actually sometimes really good to paint from memory. I think it was Pizarro, you know, one of the famous French impressionists, who said that, you know, if you can't paint from memory, you know, if you really practice painting from memory. So it's a good exercise. So I've got bluish mountains through here. There's these kind of levels to the mountains. You'll get these lighter blues that fade back in the distance and darker ridges. So I'm going to start to maybe get a little more atmosphere as these mountains fade back. And then just the desert wash in front of it. The warm orange and yellows are beautiful. And then playing with the big sky. If you come up close, you'll see sometimes I may be painting here and I'll just paint up here real quick. Sometimes that's just to unify the piece. So there's like some warm yellows in the sky. Because I don't want this to be like blue and this all orange. I want your eye to like between the two. So if you play with color like that, a really simple composition can feel really active in the whole movement. So but I also, you know, when I'm on location, the light's changing, it's windy, so I have to paint really fast. But I tend to paint fast regardless because I have that muscle or is kind of formed, and sometimes surprises happen when you paint really fast, and then sometimes with a little piece you gotta like really put in like care. But there's a certain energy that comes, I think, only if you kind of go a little more subconscious and intuitive and just improv the paint. So that's what I'm doing. So you'll see me, I do a lot of mixing and a lot of getting new paint, because it's big paint, so you'll see me pausing and mixing and adding paint, and then I'll be back here at the end. So that's what anyone has questions too, you're welcome to like just let in and ask something. I don't mind.
I have a question for you today.
Yeah.
Since you're on the moment, you're painting as you see.
Uh-huh.
And light is constantly changing. How do you know what light to capture? So it's just sort of motion when you're.
Yeah, there's a two approaches. Sometimes you find a light you really love, you maybe stick with that, and you know, I do think the more you paint, you build that visual memory. Sometimes, since my work is a bit more, I like to think of it as fluid and about like the duration of time that I was there. You know, you can do a photograph and it's a moment,
right?
But the advantage as a painter is that I'm taking time, I'm spending time there. So that sense of spending time with it, like trying to convey what it feels like to like just sit in front of a mountain or the ocean for 30 minutes, an hour, can that embed in the painting. So in that case, sometimes I just let the light change and I let it all go in the painting. So it may or may not always be a consistent light, but it's kind of getting that sense of being there, because the landscape is so dynamic and moving, but I want that sense of, like, that capital sense of a moving landscape. So, I actually don't worry too much about it. If it looks weird, I'll just do it, but at some point, I think that you're kind of being outside, you let the color and light sort of just bleeds into you, and you start to paint, intuitively picking up on it without, like, focusing on it. And then there's some point where the pain starts to take over, and you're almost more just thinking how to resolve the pain, and you're kind of using the light around you, but you're really now that's on the painting, and it's how does this color against this color, this shape work, and you just start playing with it. So, yeah. But good question. That's often, Monet was very strict about light, so he would, like, literally set up, like, 7 canvases and paint, and he had a really good sense of if the light changed, so he'd be like, a cloud would come, the light would be different, you move to the other canvas and paint, and when the light, like, got back, go back to the other and paint, and you do, like, several at a time. So some of those haystacks, and some of the things you see over and over, he may have, I can't tell you which one, but he may have done those all in a day, like, just as the light was changing. So some, it's, I think it depends on the artist and what they're wanting. Monet wanted to capture a specific light at a specific moment, and that sense of it, you know, so it depends on what you're doing. Exactly. And different artists have a different thing that just really turns them on.
The drive point today is it does. They're happy, but they have to check out 3 miles to get the car when you look at the window or something.
So there's like braces on the back, I just sling it over my shoulder. So the easel goes in a little backpack that goes on you. I sling this over my shoulder and then I just put the canvas here. So, and then if it's windy, it can be tough because I had one the other day. It was so windy and it was dark by the time it was done. Like my paper towels flew away. I had to like trek to try to find them. Like, and then the only way I could get my easel put up, I had to like if I laid the canvas on the sand, the wind was like kind of cross line, so it would keep it down. So I was like, oh, this will work. I laid the canvas down. And I put it all together, and then I picked it up, and I realized it just skimmed a layer of sand over the whole painting, so. But, it may or may not have been the best painting anyway, so, it was okay. I wasn't too heartbroken, but sometimes, but actually very rarely have I had a painting mess up. And I think since I let accidents sort of just happen, sometimes, you know, you get a little sand in it, or it scrapes on a branch because I'm hiking it out. I can always smudge it out, but sometimes I like the line, and I just leave it, just have an imprint of the moment, so.
Usually
do. It varies. I think sometimes I like to paint like late in the day, and so I literally it's gonna be dark in 30 minutes, so I have to go. So like if I have time, I could spend 3 hours on it. But sometimes those aren't the best ones because you know. So I don't know. I think I'm just like you kind of shift to a mode and you're just going. It's I don't know. Yeah, I feel like it's a little frenetic, but. It kind of lets me get a little more subconscious.
Yeah.
I mean, it changes. I mean, I think I play with it. I mean, I've had times where sometimes you have a painting and it's beautiful and you push past it, but if you're exploring, then you can get it to another place that's good. I think there's a certain sense of just usually of like oh, that feels right. And then you just stop, or, and then sometimes I get it back and sit with it, and then you can decide if it's right or not. Usually, I feel like it's pretty close to, like, if I go back into it later. Every once in a while, I'll do that, but you have to be careful because it loses, you can lose the sense of the place if you're not. And since I paint so thick, it doesn't, like, flow as beautifully, the paint, when I'm going over the top. But I've also, I had some times I went out and I, like, set a timer for 20 minutes. I'm like, I'm stopping at 20 minutes. Just as, like, a practice to be, like, because it's a place that I, like, sometimes I look at, like, in-process photos and I'd be like, oh, that was beautiful, I should have stopped. So sometimes I just, you know, it doesn't feel done because I've just started, but then I get it back. And sometimes it wasn't done, and then other times it was done, but that kind of trains, it's sort of something that's a little bit that just trained me to, like, think of, like, when is it done, or, like, stopping a little before you think it's done, and then sometimes you learn, like, oh, it actually was done. So, I don't, yeah, it's not an exact science, but I do think the more I paint, the more of a sense I have of, or maybe just more accurate I am, like, oh, yeah, it's done, time to go. So, yeah. Sometimes I will just stop and, like, clean up my palette, sit down for, like, a minute, and then come back, just to, like, see. Totally, yeah, totally different. It's just kind of, it's like some, you hit it, like, right away, and you're like, I don't know how I did that, but, like, it's it. Other times, you're like, this is a battle, I don't know, this just doesn't feel right. It's just, and you spend 3-4 hours, and sometimes those aren't as good, but then other times, you push through, and you get to a place that's every bit as good as the immediate. So I don't think there's a science to it. Sometimes it happens quick and sometimes not. So, yeah, I think so. Thank you.
wrong with that, I'm just right here. I wouldn't hurt you if I were out there. I can't promise things will work out like that. Will you kill me crying if you're good to me, that's a crime.
Give it a little. Watching. The musicians too, this is great.
You guys step up the game.
No. They're nice musicians. You like dancing a lot, I think. It's all low.
Does it help them with your pumps, or you know what I mean?
No, it's good. I mean, I use this for 30 years, and there probably are better options, because I've seen there's like metal tripod setups that are lighter, but I think it's just the like thought of figuring out what would be better. And especially if I'm going bigger, the tank is smaller, like a lot of artists, you're up here, but I still got to lean way down for the needle, so. It's not great for my posture.
I'd like the men to work at both levels. Like, some people are like, you gotta stand like 10, 20 feet from the floor. Like, I don't really agree with. I think it's beautiful, like, on the wheels too. But in some cases, it's just a different thing. So it's nice having out for both levels.
Hey, what you up to there, Nathan?
up, so work on this painting. I think it's getting kind of close. I like that balance of overworking. I think I'm going to get a little more. Maybe pop a little bright glow in the sky here. So this is... A little bit of that green that comes in.